A new study from researchers at Intermountain Healthcare finds patients who experience an e-cigarette or vaping-associated lung injury can suffer from cognitive impairment and symptoms more than a year later. Joining me today is Dr. Denitsa Blagov. She's a pulmonologist and researcher with Intermountain Healthcare. Dr. Blagov, thanks for taking the time to chat with us. These results seem very concerning pertaining to this study. Tell me a little bit more about it.
So we've been really concerned ever since the E-Valley outbreak about what actually happens to these young people when they recover. And this is the first study where we are able to report our results that really, even a year after E-Valley, patients are still impaired cognitively and have shortness of breath, and really a significant proportion have anxiety and depression.
Now, E-Valley, what does that mean? What is that?
So E-Valley, or e-cigarette or vaping-associated lung injury, really came to the forefront in the summer and fall of 2019 with the vitamin E acetate causing really severe lung injury and sending young people into intensive care units and causing many deaths. Since then, and even despite the COVID pandemic, we've continued to see predominantly young people who vape who get lung injury related to their e-cigarette use.
You know, there could still be some people, some population out there that think vaping or e-cigarettes are safer and it's okay compared to regular nicotine cigarettes. What would you say to that?
I think, unfortunately, that is a large number of people because that is part of how the advertising for e-cigarettes has really been pitched. It's around, this is a safer alternative for cigarettes. And what we're finding really over the last couple of years is that it is not safe. E-Valley is one example of really a devastating lung injury that can have serious consequences for people. But our understanding of the long-term effects of vaping are really far from over, so we still have a lot to learn there.
Knowing now these long-term effects, things that can still be going on your body, in your body, I should say, even after you've quit e-cigarettes or vaping, what can people do at this point to repair their health, repair the damage?
I think for people that have had E-Valley, really the number one thing to do is to avoid any kind of vaping or smoking, which might sound obvious, but we do find that up to a quarter of patients who have had E-Valley actually continue to vape something, so vape, nicotine, or THC. And so not vaping, so not continuing that risk, as well as just really generally trying to stay healthy. So get your vaccinations, because one lung disease makes it worse if you get others, and try to stay active and work on recovery.
What sort of resources are there for people who may be looking for them right now to try and quit e-cigarette habits?
So the Utah and really National Tobacco Cessation Line, so 1-800-QUIT-NOW is a really good resource. And on intermountain.org, we have resources for tobacco cessation referrals. And really the important thing there is not to give up, that most people who quit have quit and started multiple times. And so quitting is going to be really critically important.
Just know that there's help out there. Dr. Denitsa Blagov with Intermountain Healthcare, thank you so much. Important study. I'm glad we're able to spread the word to the community. Thank you.